Today my presentation is about constructive criticism.
First of all, what is constructive criticism?
Constructive criticism is a negative opinion given to someone to point out the fault. And it may include an advice on how can you get these faults corrected.
And the person who is receiving the criticism is not being attacked directly. For example, when your parents tell you,
you should study hard, okay? And even after I finish my presentation, some of you may start giving me negative feedbacks about my performance on the stage. So this is what constructive criticism.
And before I get to the next point, there is another type of criticism.
There is another type of criticism called destructive criticism. And this time you should know what is it so you don't get things mixed up in your head. And I'll show you what is it by hand.
And two examples of the two types.
First, we have constructive criticism. Here we have Ahmed and Khalid. Here Ahmed tells Khalid, you can get a better body shape if you went to this. On the other hand, we have destructive criticism. Here, Ahmed tells Khalid, you are fat. Now, he should attack the person directly. And he didn't give him advice and he started making fun of him. So, this is simply the difference between the two types. Now, importance of constructive criticism. In my opinion, constructive criticism is a treasure that everyone should be looking for. Because it shows you your weak points. And without it, you will never know what are your faults. So it's the key to improve yourself. But sadly, some people think that criticism is a bad thing. And all they want is compliment. Well, let me tell you something. Compliment will make you feel good just at the time. But criticism will make you better. Compliment will make you feel good, but criticism will make you better. So what do you think is more important? Compliment or criticism, I will leave the answer to you. How to handle constructive criticism? In order to get the most benefits of constructive criticism, you have to follow these steps. Step one, stop any negative feelings. When you get criticized, it may hurt at first, because human beings hate criticism. But some people take it to the next level. They start feeling angry and sad about it. And these feelings are dangerous because when you feel like this about constructive criticism, you will be unmotivated and instead of improving yourself, you will destroy yourself. So you should completely ignore these feelings and beat it. Don't let it take control of you. Ask questions. Ask questions about the point so you can get more clarity about the point you have done mistake at. Because many people have knowledge about your problem and they will not share it with you unless you ask. So make sure to ask, like, how can I improve? Where exactly did I miss them? What do you think should I do next time? Just like this. Ignore useless criticism. Some people just love to criticize. So they will always be looking for something incorrect, no matter how good you are. So they will always find a mistake that doesn't make any sense. So all you need to do is to turn on your ignore mode and start ignoring everything they say. Last step, start improving. Now you have everything you need. You know your weak points and you know how can you start improving. And all you need to do is to work hard. Although it sounds easy, but lots of people fail at this point because they don't have the willpower. So every day when they start improving, they say, man, tomorrow, inshallah, tomorrow. So you shouldn't be like this. You must be motivated. And don't delay anything to another day. Thank you for your time.